Ritchey Team Comp. That's one of my favorite bikes that that is hanging up there. That was actually my second mountain bike that I ever owned. Right when I started Pacific Bicycle in San Francisco, I wanted to bring in Ritchey mountain bikes because I thought it was a phenomenal bike for the price. I think those retailed for, I think, $1,300 back then. There were more expensive mountain bikes, but that seemed like, for a racing caliber mountain bike, I thought it was a pretty good value. One of the things that's unique on that bike are the wheels. That has the first Keith Bontrager product, which are cut down rims. You would take a 40 hole Super Champion 58 rim and cut it down to a 36 hole 26 inch rim. You'd even cut through the label so you could kind of tell that it was a Super Champion 58 that had been cut down. They were pretty good rims. You know, they were not the most indestructible rim on the market. I was always kind of a relatively small, lightweight rider, so I never had any issues with them. But it was not unheard of for those things to just buckle. Well, it has Columbus frame tubing on it, which is kind of unusual for mountain bikes. It was made by Tom Ritchey, which, I don't know if he's doing that anymore. At that point, BioPace was kind of going out of favor, so I just have it on the smallest spring. I have it on the 28. I wanted the gearing to be like my road bike. So I have it a 4252 in the front chain rings with a bailout 28. And in the rear, I have a 1324, which is what I used to use for my road bike. Those were considered road gears back then. There's no way in the world I could push that around at this point. I could, but I wouldn't be going up any hills. Every mountain bike worth its salt had a Hite-rite on it back then, like they do now. I mean, it's kind of come full circle. Back then, it's a spring that you would adjust it to where if the spring is all the way open, it puts the seat up to exactly the right height that you need it for the climbing. However, if you could reach back and undo the quick release and just sit down on it and tighten it back up, lower it down again very, very easily. Oh, the Bullmoose bars, yes. That was the way it was done on the first mountain bikes back then. I guess they really didn't want the bars to break, which was good. And they didn't really care about the rider's position. So whatever it came with is what it came with. Get used to it. Oh, I just have so many emotions attached. I mean, this is my second mountain bike, and it was one of those. It was my first really good mountain bike. I mean, lightweight, and it's really where I started exploring all over Marin County on it, and got a lot of other people into mountain biking on it. And I'm surprised I was able to keep it all these years. I didn't get rid of it or trade it because I wasn't really into collecting bikes back then. So I'm very lucky that it's still around.